Good afternoon. Welcome to the tea table. I am so happy you have joined me today. And we are going back to the most special place that I know to have tea. Yes, we're going to the Empress Hotel in Victoria, BC. And I'll tell you why. We talked about going on the boat 2 weeks ago, or three tea talks back. And then my dear friend Patricia went to Victoria and she brought me Empress tea. Oh my, and is it fabulous? Now I am sitting here and I've got all my things on my tea table, but I don't think you can quite see them. So I'm going to hold them up. This is my special tea caddy. It's called a tea caddy. It's an authentic Victorian tea caddy from 100 years ago. And in it is my special tea. And this is how it came. It came in a package and it says Empress Tea at the Empress, afternoon high tea. And it came in this bag and it is the most delicious tea. Oh my, I love it. I've been drinking it every day. And I might just adjust this a little bit so you can see the tea table. And you can kind of see what's going on here because I have a cup that years ago my husband gave me when we were up there, and the cup is so special. I actually have two. I have one for you and one for me. So I will take this one for me. And inside is the crown. You see, it's the crown and the royal orb. And then this china is the original Empress Hotel china that they reproduced in England. And I'm going to tell you the story of it. Okay. If you haven't gotten your tea yet, please pause. Get your tea and I will be waiting for you. I chose my favorite silver teapot. And here is the lovely brisk, you see, British tea. Okay. And we will have a little splash of milk. That's what I take. Everyone has a different opinion. But the British have, majority take a little milk in their tea. And that's where I learned to really drink tea with milk, was when I lived in England. Oh my goodness, that is the best tea. Oh my, so lovely. Well, I'm going to show you what my tray looks like. If I can pick it up and show you what the whole thing looks like today. See how pretty it is with the two Empress cups and the silver set and the silver tray. I've made it very, oh wow, that's heavy. I made it special for you. And then Patricia brought me this lovely tea towel from the Empress with the same crown, and on it is the recipe for afternoon tea scones. You see? And it has the same border that the china has. It's like a deep pink and a blue and a gold. And the royal crown with the royal cross and orb above it. So now I'm going, I think this would be perfect to make the scones and then cover them with this, because it's too special to use for anything else. It has to be on the tea table. Well, when I went over to my tea things, I saw this, and it's a little small to put on this pot, but my son had brought me this years ago from the Empress, and it says Tea at the Empress. And what it is, it's a little tea cozy, but it has to go over a smaller pot than this, and then it will keep the tea quite hot. And what are we having today? Whoops. We're going to have a special, special Empress cake. Empress cake. And in the olden days, when the Victorians had tea, I read they would have a chocolate cake often, or a special cake, and they would keep it all week. And every day at afternoon tea, everyone present would get a small slice. That way you didn't eat too much, but you got the taste of it. And I thought this scarf just felt old world Victorian. I think I'll put that there. And then I have these wonderful flowers, this one glad in the middle of the snapdragons. Oh, I love these colors. It's just so amazing, the colors. And I just wore some fun jewels that are, I felt, went with going to tea at the Empress. Well, I want to tell you the story of the china. You know, the china was brought to the Empress Hotel by the Queen Mum, that is the mother of the current Queen, Elizabeth Lyons, Bowes Lyons, and she was married to the Queen's father, of course, King George. And they came to visit Canada. It was a very big deal. It was in 1931. And they were very special guests because they brought 250 place settings of this beautiful china to the Empress. They hosted a dinner and invited all the Canadian leaders to come because Victoria is the capital of British Columbia. And they wanted to honor that capital. So I believe people came from all over Canada. And I don't know for sure, but I think they probably came on their yacht, because that's how the Queen came to Seattle in the 1980s. She came on her yacht. And well, they had the big dinner, and then they gave this china to the Empress. But the Empress Hotel said, oh, this is too special to use for every day. So they put it away in the basement, and everyone forgot about it. Well, then Queen Elizabeth came, and she came in 1951 for her Canadian visit, and somebody remembered the china, and so they brought it out. And they brought it out and served another great big dinner to all of the honoring guests. Well, then they put it away again, and it was forgotten. Until in the 1990s, a new owner came to the hotel and was looking through all of the basement and all the storage and finding all these unique treasures that people had brought to the Empress or left at the Empress. You know, so many famous people. I think Winston Churchill stayed at the Empress, and probably Teddy Roosevelt, you know. Everyone came, and it was such a, it was the end hotel. What the Empress was one of the British Rail's hotels, and they were all along the line from the east to the west. Well, this was the last one, built on an island. Vancouver Island, the beautiful Straits of Juan de Fuca, and they have a climate there that it's, there's like a warm Gulf Stream that comes through, and it makes everything so pleasant, and they don't have as much rain as you would think. It's almost like a mist rises and fills the island with moisture, so the flowers grow so beautifully. Well, then in 1990, when the man found them, he said, "Oh, I wonder if the original china maker still has the molds." So they wrote to England and sent a sample, and they still had the original molds designed. And so the Empress ordered china, and it was better to have the new china because some of the old china had lead in it. So this is safe. And I'll show you also that there's a lovely crown in the very center of the saucer. And you know, the crown symbolizes, yes, authority and rulership. And the cross above it, it means Jesus Christ around the world. It's a Christian country. England is a Christian country, and that's their Christian symbol. You can look it up. And the royal orb also is symbolic of rulership. You know, when the queen is crowned, or when she was crowned in the early 1950s, and she has ruled so long that there hasn't been a crowning since then. But do you know what model service they use to crown the queen or the king? It's directly out of the Bible. When King Solomon, they read all of that scripture when King Solomon was crowned. Isn't that interesting? And you can go online and watch her original crowning and in Westminster Abbey, and she sits on the throne. Underneath is a stone called the Stone of Scone, and it is very historic. And many people believe it goes back to biblical times. Many people believe it was carried through the desert and on to England. Well, and it's called sometimes Jacob's Pillow. You can look this up. It's a very fascinating study. Well, I thought for going to the Empress, this is my hat. Do you like it? I'm kind of off the screen because I moved the screen back. I think I'll move the screen up again. Never done this moving of the screen during my tea talk, but I want to show you my blue and white vases behind me that are also so Victorian. And they're sitting there on the fireplace. And I love blue and white. We all do. It goes with everything. Well, this is a very fun purse that I thought I will bring this for my tea. It's a handmade, one-of-a-kind designer purse. And it's just got everything on it. And I thought it was so fun with the black. And I have this shawl that kind of has these flowers that glitter and kind of look like the purse. Let's push this down again. Okay, now, see? Kind of goes with the flowers. You know, I've found that with color, you can just about put anything together. It all works. It's fun to be an artist with your clothing. You know, I really always wanted to be a graphic artist. I wanted to paint people. To me, anyone that can paint people is the true artist, that can do the portraits and do the likeness. And I really never had a chance to go to art school. I was always in music, which I also appreciate. But so my art form is my surroundings, my china, my clothes, my purse, my hat, and my decorations. And I just have to have color. We all do. We all have to have color. And look at these flowers, so spectacular. The colors are just over the top. Such variety. Well, the Empress Hotel, my friend had tea at the Empress, and she said it was fabulous. And you know, they bring the three-tiered tray, and it has the scones, the little sandwiches, and the little sweets. For us today, we're just going to have the Victorian cake. And I think that's enough. But if you're going to have a real high tea, that is really a meal. It is a lunch. And I went last Saturday with another dear friend who took me as a guest to a high tea at a special restaurant called The Trellis. And that was very, very special. And that was formal high tea. And we all got our own teapot. And so that was my friend Robin who took four of us out as a gift. And that was so special. And so there are tea rooms around. That was in Puyallup, up on Meridian. And then there's the one I want to go back to, I haven't been for years, is Seattle, the Queen Mary. It's just the traffic where we live. To get to Seattle, it would be easier sometimes to fly to London. And I'm not joking. Oh my goodness, my son is coming home today and he's coming from Boise, which should be a breeze. You go through Eastern Oregon, then along the Columbia River and up to Olympia. He has been stuck in traffic for 2.5 hours, not moving, stand still. Wow. I don't know what's gonna happen. Oh my goodness. And you have no way of knowing what happened up above. You know, there's no setup yet where you can go online and push a button and say, what's going on? Or, you know, is there an alternative route? Or just there. Wow. Ooh. Well, I also wanted to tell you that we have had sunshine and flowers. My flowers, in 2 days of sun, they just went, whew, they went wild. They love the sun. We all need the sun. Yes, we do. And of course, we need a little rain and we need a little wind and we even need a little snow. We need everything. But for right now, I am enjoying the sun. And I was sitting out by the water and I felt like I was in Italy, up, you know, by the Riviera where you overlook Portofino and all of that. Oh my goodness. And smelling that sea air. I can only imagine the espresso coffee in the air from Italy. Wonderful combination. Well, are you going anywhere this summer? I think you should, if you can. We are going to go this week to Montana. We have a new little grandchild, and we are going to meet her. Her name is Cambria. And so we are going to go on a little road trip. And so I'm getting all packed up and trying to get it all organized and to get out the door. You know, if you can get out the door, get in the car, then you're home free. Then you can relax and enjoy. But in the meantime, I have many, many things to do. You know what that's like. Yes. And I also thought this week of all of you, and you know, people, tea has become so dominant. I got my Victoria magazine in the mail, and it, the autumn issue, September, you can buy it at the newsstand. I know you can get it at Barnes and Noble's. If you don't subscribe, that is a beautiful issue. It's on Scotland and the royal castles and the royal life in Scotland. And they were showing all the wonderful tea and the tea cakes and the customs of Scotland. Each country is so unique. But so many things have come from Scotland. And I was reading a quote there from, of all people, Voltaire, who was French, and he was a philosopher, and he said, everything good in the whole world has come from Scotland. Now, I don't know fully what he was basing it on, but I have read books about the fact that Scotland and Ireland literally saved Western civilization. You know, they had writing and copying in those monasteries in the Middle Ages when no one else was writing or reading. They were ahead. And then on a little royal note, I don't know if I've ever told you about Queen Margaret. She's one of my favorite people in all of history. And she is 12th century Scotland. And she actually was a princess that had been, their family had been in Hungary with the Hungarian royal house, even though they were British. Somehow they were hiding there because of a war situation. Well, they came back and decided to come to England, but their boat got in a terrible storm and they almost capsized, but they washed ashore instead of England in Scotland. Well, the king heard that a princess was there, so he sent for her and her brother and welcomed them and took care of them. Well, Margaret was a beautiful woman and a very noble, virtuous, good woman. She was a real Christian. And the Scottish throne at that time had gotten pretty rough. And she didn't say anything, but he fell in love with her and wanted to marry her. So she married him. And I believe she had like 5 to 7 children. But Margaret, it said, her love and her virtue and her beauty was so great that she brought to the throne refinement. And all of the rough men wanted to be noble and good. And just by her life, she influenced an entire throne. You can look her up, Queen Margaret, in history. And because of her greatness, there are statues of her in Scotland. And there is a Saint Margaret. They made her a saint. She would go and feed the poor and wash the feet of the poor. She went right out to the poverty people and won their hearts. She wasn't doing it for that. She was doing it to really, truly help and be a Christian. And so there is a Saint Margaret Society, and everyone that's named Margaret, it's a very popular Scottish name. Peggy, you know, is the nickname for Margaret. And so there's a Margaret Society, and anyone that's named Margaret can be a member of it. And they are very strong in Scotland, and it's very, very well known. And so that's my little story for history today, that just by our lives, by our love, by our kindness, by our goodness to others, we can change the atmosphere. We can bring beauty into very difficult places. We can bring love and we can bring joy where there is sorrow. So I encourage you, think about Margaret and these people I talk about. What's so great about Google? Look them up. Look up Princess Margaret, and then she was Queen Margaret of Scotland in the 11th or 12th, it's in the late Middle Ages. And don't get her mixed up. She's not Queen Mary. That was later in the 1500s. No, she's not the Mary. She's Margaret. Okay. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this. And I hope you can go to my channel if you haven't and subscribe. Push the notification bell. Push the like button and share with someone. Everyone is welcome to the tea table. Okay, well, I hope you have a wonderful week. keep your teacup close, and I will look forward to seeing you next time. God bless.